603-883-9900. Mike's in Manson. Mike, how are you?
Hey, how's it going?
What's up, man?
I don't know why you're so fired up about this. Did Gordon Eade say something that was derogatory to what Tutcher and Rich did?
No.
He didn't?
No.
So he didn't have a problem with what Tutcher and Rich did?
He wrote, radio talk show hosts don't typically show up to the pregame sessions, which is true, but Valentine presented WEEI's Glenn Ordaway with a gift soundbite last week, so perhaps EEI's rival were looking for the same.
Okay, well, see, that right there is the problem, because I actually think that it's a legitimate question that Rich asked at the press conference, that none of the other beat writers have seen ask this Red Sox organization. And that's the problem with Gordon Eade and the rest of these beat writers, is they're all in the bag for the team. And I don't care that he's been writing for the team for 15 years and covering this team. None of these guys have held this organization to a standard that they should be held to. You want to have the highest ticket prices in baseball, and you want to charge $8.50 beers and tell me to buy your bricks and your stupid coffee table book? Well, if you don't put a team on the field that's going to perform, and you have a clown for a manager, I want someone to ask the hard questions.
You're absolutely right. I'm not saying anything that you're wrong. I agree with you. We've said that all of this year. Everything that you just said has been said by Gordon Eade, by the way, as well. By Gordon himself. Gordon has said this and written the same thing.
But if Gordon Eade is going to stand up in the press conference and ask those tough questions, he shouldn't look down his nose at anyone else that does.
I don't think anyone's looking down their nose. If Rich had left it alone,
Why would he bring in the Ordway interview?
Did they not build that up? Did they not act like they were going to walk in here and ask Bobby Valentine a really tough, serious, hard-hitting question because they want to be the quote voice of the fans? Did they not say that?
Yes. Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So they're walking into the press conference with a pre-thought-out agenda to go and get Bobby to answer a quote tough question, right?
An agenda, yeah, a tough question, yes.
Okay, so they have an agenda to go quote put Bobby Valentine. They're going to hold his feet to the fire. Okay. I don't care about the question, but to ask that question at the first question out of the gate.
Why does it need to be a warm-up? No, fine.
Look, I understand with all of this. I don't like when the question was asked. I don't totally disagree with the question's premise, okay? If it was left alone, I wouldn't have talked about this. This would not have been a topic if it didn't become about Gordon Eade's. If it didn't call Gordon Eade's a prick.
Why did Gordon Eade have to mention it?
Because Gordon Eade is a reporter, and something happened in a press conference.
He's a reporter who refuses to report on why the Red Sox have been sucking for the past years.
Do you read Gordon Eade's?
Yeah, I do.
And you think he doesn't report on why the team's bad? He said to fire Bobby Valentine like 5 times. He's going to walk from his hometown to Boston because he was so wrong about this team. And when did he
start writing about firing Bobby Valentine?
When the team was horrible in August.
He also wrote that article tongue-in-cheek saying, here, roses are everywhere.
Probably when the team was probably putting into his ear because he's an ESPN Boston writer, and I know you guys are right holders, and I don't want, you know.
No, it's fine, but do you think the Red Sox actually tell writers what to write?
I think they strongly suggest what they want covered.
I think they have certain influence over different types of people. But remember, the Kraft Industries owns ESPN Boston. The Patriots own ESPN Boston, not the Red Sox. So in terms of why would the Patriots ever want to defend the Red Sox? No, they're not.
Are they not a rights holder?
No, there's no rights holders.
Is there not a partnership between ESPN Boston and WEEI?
Oh, that's true, but I'm talking about the Red Sox.
Does WEEI carry the Red Sox games or not? Are they not the flagship station of the Red Sox?
Okay, now you're getting into a whole like conspiracy theory here about going down the line of four or five different companies. Which one is it?
It's business. Listen, I know you guys have a job to do, but no offense. ESPN on a whole just does not want to ask hard questions, does not want to do hard-hitting stuff. The only hard-hitting stuff they do is the 30 for 30. The rest of it's a clown show of sucking up to these organizations and these right holders. It's a joke. It's why I don't watch ESPN. You're the only thing.
How do you not watch ESPN? As a sports fan, how is that possible?
Okay. Do I watch games? Yes.
Okay.
Do I watch 30 for 30? Yes. But do I watch any of those stupid talk shows where they lob softball
questions? Yeah, sure. And
morons?
Right.
No. But I don't take them seriously.
But hold on, I read things too, though.
I read from ESPN Boston with a total grain of salt because I think they're all in the bag.
Okay, so who's not?
Have a hard job to do.
Who's not in the bag? If everyone,
you know what?
Who's not in the bag?
I will say this: some organizations are less in the bag than others. How about that? And I commend, you know, people in this town in the media market that are trying to, you know, if you want to say what Touch and Rich did was for bit and for ratings, yeah, fine. Was it childish? Yeah, sure, mate. But you know what? I respect anyone who goes out there and tries to find the tough answers to the tough questions that so many other people seem to not want to ask.
But what did, honest to goodness, what did Rich accomplish this morning with Bobby Valentine? Did you not think that he was going to answer the way he answered?
I honestly don't know.
I mean, come on. I mean, if somebody went to your job and asked you, I would like you to make the case for why I should keep you here, would you not look at him and go,
what? Part of sports is entertainment.
Yeah, but absolutely. But my point is, we all knew the answer to the question. This wasn't a unique question. This was just a got you question. This was a guy trying to get a response out of Bobby Valentine. Everybody in the media who's around Bobby, all the beat writers laughed at it because they said, you know what? We all knew the answer to that question before you asked it. That was for show. That wasn't going to accomplish anything.
It doesn't. I think it does. I think if Bobby Valentine wants to answer the question, very honestly, he could say, well, you know what? Next year I plan on I'm going into this maybe with a different approach, maybe talking to management about this. I honestly think that we're set up next year to do what's right and to make some improvements in the baseball team. It's a totally legitimate question.
I'm not
painting him into a corner at all. He gave him plenty of rope to hang himself with.
Just to get my two cents in here, Mike, you know, because I'm in a way in between both you and Matt, where I don't have a problem with the question. I don't even have a problem that it was first. I don't have a problem with Gordon Eads writing what he did. The only problem I do have is that Toucher and Rich basically called this guy a prick. And I could tell you, just knowing Gordon, he is not in the bag with EEI. He reported on something that he saw, and he probably thought it was more like a throwaway piece that, hey, this happened, and that's it. I don't think he did it for EEI. I don't think he did it for the Red Sox. And you know what? I think Toucher and Rich are very talented at what they do, but to call Gordon, I mean, that was to call him a condescending prick was a little bit too much.
I agree with you. I think that went over the line because, honestly, when I heard it this morning about when they called Eads that, and I actually read it, I didn't think it warranted the response. I mean, I still think that I question mentioning the Ordway interview and whatnot. But in all fairness, don't you think it's hard for guys in Boston that actually are in the media market, that actually kind of live on the edge and ask the tough questions? Don't you think that there's an element of the sports writer population, the team writers, that probably has looked down on them for many years, and maybe there's been some conversations or some things said behind the scenes that maybe warranted that outburst.
Now you're going into a whole different conversation because there has been a fight between talk radio hosts and beat writers since the talk radio medium started, because talk radio people, we say things every day that those writers could not say to Dustin Pedroia. Because they would not get any... They wouldn't get anything else. Their jobs would be dead. They wouldn't be able to work in that environment anymore. They'd be worthless to the papers or outlets that they cover. We can say all that. We can say all those things. So there is a level of strife between both writers and talk shows. But the problem that I have is that when you look at a respected guy like Gordon Eads and you call him a blogger, I mean, Mike, I'm assuming you grew up around here, so you've read Gordon Eads for years in the Boston Globe covering the Red Sox.
I'm not from around here, so I bring an outsider's perspective.
Okay, well, fine. Then you're on the same level with Touch and Rich. Gordon Eads is the guy that I grew up when I was in my teenage years reading while he covered the Red Sox for the Boston Globe. This is a guy with a long track record of being one of the more respected writers in this region and even in the whole country covering baseball. And
it's like Reese of baseball in a way.
He's way beyond Reese. Right. I mean, he's way beyond
Reese. Just trying to make some comparable.
He's the Will McDonough. I mean, he's on that level. I mean, he's a guy who's been around forever. Mike, it's a great call. I'm way up against it. Thank you for calling and appreciate your insight. It blew my mind. I'm sorry to sound like I wanted to come to the defense. I'm going to fight against Toucher and Rich. Baloney. As I said, I'm going with a pea shooter against a cannon. I got a butter knife in a shotgun fight. I'm not trying to come and start some fight with Toucher and Rich. Is that the point? The point is that Gordon comes on this show every single Friday, breaks news on this show every single Friday, and I couldn't allow a show to say that about a guy that I have so much respect for and get away with it when I have a microphone to talk into. That's all. Rant over, soapbox.
Yeah, off. No, in a way, the argument almost reminded me of Joe Haggerty, where, you know, he's a guy that doesn't cover, he's not on the beat, but when he went out there for the first time and saw John Lackey walking around with two beers and then said something about it, the reporters are like, what are you doing? You know, and not that it's the same thing.
Yeah, I think it's a completely different situation.
Well, no, it shows you, because Joe Haggerty's, he's almost that tweener, where he's not a beat writer for the Red Sox, and he's sometimes on TV and radio.
Again, this bit does not get talked about if they did not call Gordon Eads what they called him.
Right. And I agree with
you. I don't talk about it. I don't mention it. It's just a run-of-the-mill day, you know, talking to guys waking up, shaking off their hangovers. I mean, it's just a run-of-the-mill day for them. It's what they do all the time. That's their gag. They have huge ratings. I get it. People love them. They're funny. Rich, I've said this off the air 1,000 times. I'll say this at the end, is the most talented production guy I have ever heard in my life. He has amazing abilities with radio. I mean, he is, you know, if you find someone better than him, I've never come across them. I've never heard them in my life. Okay. But that was Fred saying that. And it's amazing that the guy who went to the press conference, who asked the questions, wasn't the guy saying that about Gordon Eads. That was even more ironic to me that, wait a minute, the guy who went to the press conference is not the one deciding to go after Gordon Eads for no reason. I mean, what's funny? Why is it that whenever somebody gets big in New England, they get hypersensitive? They get rabbit ears for everything. Again, Gordon Eads wrote about you. Just take it and leave it alone. Just take it and leave it alone.
I'd be thrilled if Gordon Eads wrote about me.
Just take it and leave it alone.
You can write about me any day you want.
Because you know what? If you want to compare hits on a website, go compare ESPN Boston traffic to CBS Sports traffic. Not even close. ESPN Boston is one of the highest trafficked websites in the ESPN family, and ESPN is the number one website in the world.
No, and to me, I thought Gordon Eads' piece about a month ago with the tongue-in-cheek piece where he basically said, okay, Red Sox brass, you want us to be nice to you? Here, we'll be nice to you. Last night, they lost 9-0 on a glorious pitcher, but, you know, I mean, it was a very creative article, and he was basically sticking it to the Red Sox ownership.
Again, who am I? Fine. But I'm just a guy that wants to defend someone who I have a lot of respect for, and it was really uncalled for this morning. Audio Quick gets up next.
Dave Long's Red Sox Notebook.
Colby Ellsbury.